Hey guys, so this is a video that I've had on my minds for quite some time, and I've really sort of had to go back and forth on if I really wanted to shoot this or not, but I feel like why not? It doesn't hurt. It's just my opinion on something on one of my favorite franchises of all time. So before I get too deep into it, let's go ahead and explain as to my thought processes behind making this video. Now, as I said before, I am a lifelong Power Rangers fan, so there was obviously a point where I sort of became less interested in it. I started growing up, having other interests, things like that. But it's always been in my heart. It's always been one of those franchises that I've always loved more than anything. I mean, there's only like three franchises that I've loved ever since I was a kid, and it's never stopped, this being one of them. So I really want to take a look back and try and figure out what it was that really caused this disinterest for me. Now it's coming up on the 25th anniversary of the original Power Rangers that the franchise has been running. So there's been almost 24, 25 seasons of various Power Rangers now. And it's been a long road. It's been a long time. So I figured, why not take a look back and figure out what exactly is the downfall in this franchise and what's led down this path of it becoming this massive franchise in the beginning to now where it's sort of like this mediocre, not so interesting series, and what really happened to it. So I've essentially broken it down into a couple of key areas that I think these downfalls have contributed to. And the first key area of those downfalls is actually the morphing sequence. Now, the morphing sequence has been one of the most key factors in the franchise. I would dare say it's the definitive moment of every single episode, and let's be honest, it's the moment we all look forward to the most. This key sequence has become so convoluted with useless motions, actions, and movements that it just becomes so useless. It's kind of fun to reenact if you're a kid or if you're new to the franchise, but every single motion has become utterly useless and pointless in the whole morphing sequence. Take, for example, the original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Although the movement is simple as putting your hand behind your back and then cutting to the Rangers' faces saying their dino power name and morph, it may seem dumb, it's actually really effective. Now let's compare that to 2006 Mystic Force, or even the most recent series Ninja Steel, where they have overly long and complicated motions and morphing sequences that border on plain boring. Now I understand the advancement in technology since 1993 with the original series, and how a lot of the budget has gone into these morphing sequences, and yes, I will admit, some of them are pretty damn cool. But when you think about it, some of them can take up to 2 minutes for 5 to 6 Rangers to completely morph. That's pretty insane when you consider the original 1993 series took about, on average, about 10 seconds for the Rangers to be in their costumes. And this contrast can seem pretty vast when if you consider that the Rangers morph every single episode in a 30-minute episode, that if you take out for commercials, it's going to be about 20-22 minutes. Take about 2 minutes every single episode out. So now you have about 18 minutes, 20 minutes to actually fulfill a story arc in a single episode, which is simply not enough with these long morphing sequences. And while we're on the topic of morphing, let me bring up my next subject, the morphers themselves. They started out as a simple morpher that was much like a belt buckle, often held behind the back. Then eventually the series escalated to more wrist wear, and then eventually into like an old school flip phone like devices. Then the series started hitting new lows when they became sunglasses to this weird capsule thing that they put into a flare gun. And if that's not bad enough, they even eventually moved on to this weird mouth thing that you put cards into like it's a Yu-Gi-Oh! Episode, and then the most recent spinning top thing. My point is that these devices have simply gotten out of hand. Oftentimes, less is more, and by creating these bulky, chunky devices, even when you can pull them out of thin air to create morph every single time, it kind of seems inconvenient when you have to morph on a weekly basis. Now let's move away from the morphing and the morphers and talk about the series themselves and the titles and themes. Mighty Morphin Power Rangers was the cornerstone of them all. It was the best with the dinosaur theme and the name and everything worked beautifully together. Then the show went into Zeo, which was in my opinion a great follow-up series. After that came Turbo, which was alright, and then a franchise was somewhat redeemed there afterwards with In Space. Then it took another small hit with Lost Galaxy, which was one of my least favorite ones, and then came back big with Lightspeed Rescue and Time Force. In my opinion, after Time Force, it became a slippery slope of no longer caring. I knew the series had hit an all-time low when Mystic Force rolled around. This was the series that frustrated me the most, just based on the theme and the addition of the Rangers wearing capes. I just feel that the producers and executives really stopped caring about the show at this point. They no longer cared about creating good quality content with great stories. All they cared about was being transparent as possible and just being this nonsense that was constantly occurring and just going out there to sell toys. The franchise became so lazy that they have recycled titles by simply adding Super to it, not once or twice, but a total of 4 times, with the upcoming 25th season entitled Super Ninja Steel. How lazy is that? They simply do not care. Not to mention that they've also recycled the same themes several times with dinosaurs, samurai, and ninja themes. But one of the worst offenders, in my opinion, is Super Mega Force, when they literally can choose whichever ranger they want from the past and do the Yu-Gi-Oh method and put a card in a thing and they can be that ranger. This is, in my opinion, the epitome of laziness. Why come up with something new if we did something successful in the past? But hands down, where the franchise has constantly buckled over the past 25 years has definitely been with the characters. The original characters, although not the strongest, we stuck through with them through all the ups and downs of being teenagers, which is another topic that I'll tackle in a minute, but at least they were able to evolve and we shared a journey with them through several iterations. But the best story arcs and elements of the franchise, in my opinion, came from In Space and Time Force. They had at least 1 to 2 decent characters that you actually cared about with meaningful arcs throughout the season, and even reached a conclusion by the end, which is the structure of most every successful story. Every other season, however, pretty much fails at this miserably with weak characters with little to no motivation, and we never cared about them until they morphed. But let me backtrack to that teenager element that I was talking about just a minute ago. Let's be honest, the franchise lost a lot of respect for itself once they again disregarded their audience and didn't care about making connections. Teenagers with attitude is what Zordon was looking for when he recruited the original Rangers. Now it has become any person who looks youngish and that's it. I mean, the main audience for the show are either diehard fans or young kids. So with most of the casting choices, I have no idea what their thought processes are. They essentially choose the youngish, prettyish people and hope it sticks. Yet somehow most seasons do not get a running theme or second seasons without follow-up seasons or any continuations unless you count the super iterations that they've been releasing. Now I'm not sure if this is any relation to our society or lack of attention spans, but in my eyes, the original had 3 seasons, but the characters evolved. And even when some characters moved on, they were properly replaced with people previous Rangers picked, and we even get the reasons why they were chosen, and the show even evolved with different themes into Zeo, which was again a nice step forward, and continuing the characters that we connected with in Mighty Morphin. And they also attempted this same method through Turbo and connecting up until In Space. Now that's a pretty epic story arc, with reasonable character and power changes for the most part if you ask me. It's not perfect, but at least it was when they were trying. Now every character and theme feels weak, disposable, and transparent. Now the biggest leap that the franchise and the brand itself has taken has been the 2016 reboot film that was most recently come out. Now this was a big deal for me because it was obviously the reboot, but it wasn't well received. But why though? The short answer? It tried. It tried to take a risk and go back to the roots of the franchise with the original theme and characters and do a lot of fan service as well as create characters that were relatable and had real life issues that could be connected with, as well as bold costume design and pushing themselves with taking what they knew worked in the original and modernizing it. The movie was far from perfect like a majority of the franchise, but at least it tried and that's what's important to me. The bad news is that I think that the franchise's path has not ended, nor will it change. I think that the TV series will continue with the downward trend, and unfortunately, I don't know if there will be a sequel to the most recent film, but I hope they are willing to take a chance. Because it had 12 times more potential than the last 14 or so seasons of the television series combined. Now it may seem like I'm being super unfair to this franchise, and I'm hitting it really hard on some points that maybe a lot of may disagree with, but these are just things that I think have really changed the franchise for the worse, and I think that they do have a lot of potential in this new franchise with the new movie series. There's a lot of potential there with these characters, and I think that they can do a lot of great things with it. However, I don't think they're willing to take that risk. They're willing to go with the formula that worked, the one that's still working, that's still based on the 1993 series, that is very much reminiscent of that time. It's very campy, has a lot of stupid dialogue. Everything there, it just seemed to work then. They expect it to work now, and unfortunately, that's just not the case. Now, again, let me reiterate that I am a lifelong fan of the Power Rangers. I know this video may seem a bit harsh in a lot of the areas that I've discussed, but I don't think that it's unfair. I think there are mostly valid points, at least in my eyes. But then again, I became very disinterested in the franchise right after Time Force. So there are a lot of seasons that I sort of missed. But I still have followed it for the most part throughout my life. And this 25th anniversary, I really hope that things sort of click and can change for them. Again, I don't think it's going to be bounced back like I want, but I can hope for the best. And like I said, these are all my own personal opinions. I would love to hear more of what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you think that I'm right on a lot of these topics? Do you think that maybe I missed something because I did pretty much stop watching after Time Force? What is your personal opinion? Did I miss something that really could add to this argument? Do you think Saban could really make that leap? Because they recently did drop the licensing for the new logo for the movies. This could mean that they're not going to pursue those movies any longer, or it could mean that they might try and evolve it. Most likely they're dropping it because they're not moving forward. Again, it was all mostly based on toy sales. The movie basically made its money back, just barely. But I really liked it. It did take those risks and leaps, and I think it's worth at least giving it one sequel. I mean, we've seen sequels come out for movies much, much worse. So I don't see the point in not at least giving it that chance. But again, let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section below. But other than that, that's pretty much all I have on my thoughts on this whole Power Rangers franchise thing. Got it out of my system now, so hopefully I can move on. So make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, because I will be having my Stranger Things review come out pretty soon. I'm working through it right now. I have to kind of balance it with trying to work and everything like that. I'm trying to binge it as much as possible, but I'll get there when I get there. But yeah, that's pretty much all I have for now. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.